When I'm talking about virtue, I'm talking about the notion of public virtue. And when we get to the section dealing with the bloody impeachment battle, and Ken Starr's published his report, and then the House impeaches President Clinton, and people are just fighting to the death, Time magazine at the end of the year, and I don't know if any of you remember this, had both President Clinton and Ken Starr on the cover of the magazine. And this is what they wrote. For rewriting the book on crime and punishment, for putting prices on values we didn't want to rank, for fighting past all reason, a battle whose casualties will be counted for years to come, Bill Clinton and Kenneth Starr are Time's Men of the Year. There were times, I think, in our country as recently as when Archibald Cox and Elliot Richardson and folks like that populated government posts, when exercising restraint was understood as being just as much a part of public service as burning down the house to win at all costs. And so if I were to explain this to Sarah Palin, I guess I'd say going rogue has its costs. So what's the relevance of all of this today? I do think that this was a watershed in many ways, in a very negative and intensely negative way. This was unlike any other political upheaval in modern times, and most of you here lived through it. The angry clash that we had here, you had Watergate before, you had the Bork confirmation hearings, but this was the popularization of that polarization. You could go into any supermarket and find people with their veins bulging out of their necks arguing over who was the bad guy here. And incidentally, a lot of people haven't realized this. You see President Clinton on the front, but here's the other side. You can't see except from a distance, but it's Ken Starr. So this story is not about black and white and good and evil. I think if you look in the mirror and examine the facts honestly, both sides have to share some of the blame. And I'm not just talking about Ken Starr the man and Bill Clinton the man. I'm talking about the angry cohorts that grew up around them in Washington, in Little Rock, in Pittsburgh, in every part of the country. We lost our compass, folks, and this was the beginning, in my view, of the red states and blue states and separate television channels for liberals and conservatives.